Hello friends, welcome to ELS, English Literature Studies with Gaur Harpreet. Today we'll discuss Shakespearean sonnet versus Petrarchan sonnet, Shakespeare's sonnet versus Spenserian sonnet, and Shakespearean sonnet versus Miltonic sonnet. So let's get started. And before starting, let us revise what is sonnet, right? The word sonnet is derived from the Italian word sonetto, which itself derives from suono, and this word means a sound, right? There are four primary types of sonnets. These are the four types: Petrarchan, Spenserian, Shakespearean, and Miltonic. Only Miltonic is not discussed by me on my channel, and rest of the sonnets are discussed in detail. If you're interested, you can check those videos. I will provide link in the description box. And if you want full-fledged information about these sonnets, then it is already discussed. Today my topic is about Shakespearean sonnet versus all this sonnet, right? But it is better to discuss these sonnets firstly for those who are on my channel for the first time, right? Now, what is Petrarchan sonnet? First of all, I will discuss these types one by one, then I will discuss to the rest of the points, right? Let me tell you that Petrarch is not the originator of this poetic form that is known as Petrarchan sonnet, but it bears his name, right? It is named after the Italian poet Petrarch, a lyrical poet of 14th century, right? Rather, the originator of this sonnet is Giacomo da Lentini, who composed poetry in the literary Sicilian dialect, right, in the 13th century. The sonnet, Petrarchan sonnet, has 14 lines, which is divided into two subgroups, an octave and a sestet, right? And the octave, it follows a rhyme scheme of A, B, B, A, A, B, B, A. And the sestet follows one of two rhyme schemes, right? Either C, D, E, C, D, E, which is very common in use, or C, D, C, C, D, C, right? Next type is Shakespearean sonnet. Friends, I'm repeating myself that these sonnets are discussed in detail, already discussed on my channel. If you're interested, you can check those videos, right? Today, I will just give it a sort of revision, right? Now, what is a Shakespearean sonnet? Shakespearean sonnet is a variation on the Italian sonnet tradition, right? And the form evolved in England during and around the time of Elizabethan era. And these sonnets are sometimes referred to as Elizabethan sonnets or English sonnets. And again, these sonnets have 14 lines divided into four subgroups. Petrarchan sonnet, 14 lines divided into two subgroups, and Shakespearean sonnet, 14 lines divided into four subgroups, three quatrains and one couplet, right? And each line is typically 10 syllables phrased in iambic pentameter, right? And when we talk about its rhyme scheme, a Shakespearean sonnet has rhyme scheme A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, E, F, G, G. Means in quatrains we have this rhyme scheme A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, E, F, and for couplet we have this rhyme scheme G, G, right? Next is, what is Spenserian sonnet? Spenserian sonnet is a variation on the Shakespearean sonnet, as Shakespearean sonnet is a variation on Italian sonnet. In the same ways, a Spenserian sonnet is a variation on the Shakespearean sonnet with a more challenging rhyme scheme. Now, it has more challenging rhyme scheme A, B, A, B, B, C, B, C, C, D, C, D, E, E, right? A, B, A, B. Now, B from this, B, C, B, C. Then C from this, C, D, C, D, then E, E, right? Last one is Miltonic sonnet. I will discuss it in detail later on. Shakespearean Miltonic sonnets are, we can say, an evolution of the Shakespearean sonnet, right? And they often examined an internal struggle. Or we can say they examined conflicts rather than themes, rather than talking about the material world. The theme rather than material world, these sonnets are concerned with internal struggle or conflict which is going inside the mind, right? And sometimes they would stretch beyond traditional limits on rhyme or length also. Now, our topic, today's main topic is Shakespearean sonnet versus other sonnets. First of all, I would like to discuss Shakespeare's sonnet versus Miltonic sonnet, right? This 17th century form was created by English poet John Milton. Miltonic sonnet, the elements of the Miltonic sonnet are leaving the 14 lines unbroken by stanzas, right? John Milton, who lived for the final 8 years of Shakespeare's lifetime, he continued to push the sonnet form, right? As already mentioned, that his sonnets often examined an internal struggle rather than the themes of the material world. Sometimes they would stretch beyond traditional limits, but it is not wrong to say that Milton also showed fondness for the Petrarchan form, right? And his such fondness we can read in his most famous sonnet named as "When I Consider How My Light Is Spent," right? This form is very much clear in that sonnet. Now let us talk about Shakespearean sonnet style. Shakespearean rhyme scheme differed from its Italian precedents. If we have a look at his work, The Bard of Avon, distinguished his style via his poem's content and themes, right? Prior to Elizabethan age, the majority of sonnets were concerned about religion and worship. Shakespeare who changed this tradition with poems through his poem's content and through his themes. It is he who changed this tradition using features as lust and infidelity, etc. Right? Next is Shakespearean sonnet versus Petrarchan sonnet. Both sonnets have 14 lines. Then now question arises how these are different from each other when both have 14 lines. The primary difference between Shakespearean sonnet and Petrarchan sonnet is the way the poem's 14 lines are grouped. Right, this is the main difference. First of all, I would like to discuss Petrarchan sonnet. They have 14 lines subdivided into two subgroups, octave and sestet. Right, octave follows the rhyme scheme of ABBA ABBA, and sestet follows CDE CDE, which is commonly used, or CDC, right? And Shakespeare's sonnet again have 14 lines, but it is divided into four subgroups. It has three quatrains and a couplet, and each line is typically 10 syllables phrased in iambic pentameter, and its three quatrains rhyme scheme is ABABCDCDEFEF, and couplet rhyme scheme is GG, right? Next is Shakespeare's sonnet versus Spenserian sonnet. Shakespeare's rhyme scheme we know. Right, now next is Spenserian sonnet. This type of sonnet, Spenserian sonnet, or Edmund Spenser, are already discussed on my channel. Content regarding them is already available. I will just give it a brief view that the English poet Edmund Spenser lived during the age of Shakespeare, right, and provided his own variation on the popular sonnet form of that age, of that day. And Shakespeare and most of his contemporaries organized their 14 line sonnet sequence with the rhyme scheme ABABCDCDEEF EF and GG. And Spenser's, when we talk about Spenserian sonnet, his rhyme scheme is ABABBCBCCDCDEE, right? So friends, this is all about these sonnets. I have just given it a sort of revision. I hope you will like the content, and if you like it, please hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel. If you are new my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. Thanks a lot for watching.